For the second part of our New York trip, we leave the artists of Soho to look at another kind of artist whose work over the past few years has appeared all over New York, if indeed what's done can be called art at all. Some people brand it vandalism. It's done surreptitiously and sometimes dangerously. In our film, it's New Yorkers themselves who tell us about it.
Yourself, you know, to get up with. When you think of a name, you know, everybody has a name. It's like to signify you. And then you can accompany with a number. You know, let's say there's more than one of you.
Most of the graffiti seems to take a form of individual names and numbers, but we never see any kind of obscene graffiti. It's extremely rare to see four-letter words or any kind of pictured graffiti. Very, very rare.
Well, I think maybe it's a pattern of the times. I believe it's youngsters who are trying to find expression. Maybe the hard times, social upheaval, could be a form of art also.
The mark is the same as a dog staking out its territory, you know, when it walks down the block and makes its little mark. That's what these kids are doing. And this gives them a sense of identification. And it's like, look, this is me.
Yeah!
We use many different chemicals, solvents, and acids, and base materials to remove graffiti. But very often we have difficulty removing the stains that are kind of a residue of graffiti that are absorbed right into porous stones like this one.
This is another one of our
chemicals. Vasco.
Vasco. Vasco.
We have a special graffiti squad consisting of a sergeant and about a dozen men who are particularly knowledgeable in the workings of the graffitis and the identification of them.
Where do you ride?
All over. Trains, buses, vans, trucks, anything. Signs,
telephone poles.
Psychologists have claimed that it's a sort of a self-identification. The type of graffiti we've been seeing in the last 10 years is that usually involving a kid's name and a number, and the number is usually the street number, maybe the block number. So it's been names like you see here, Bub 143 and Pito 159. These are typical names.
Kid, Scat,
Nisha. Why did you choose those?
They sounded nice, so I decided to write them.
Used to be a movie out. It was a book called The Godfather. And, you know, everybody used to write that. So I used to write The Godfather, and one of my friends came up to me and said, hey, why don't you write what's short for it? And I said, he said, Don. So I told him, yeah, Don sounds all right. So that's when I started hitting it.
My graffiti name? God, I have a lot of them. I just use all different kind of graffiti names, nothing in particular.
What about a monument like this? Some people would say you're defacing this monument.
Are we just helping a little?
This is something. You see your name on the train, say, yeah, that's me.
You see a nice clean wall, right away you get the urge to start writing on it. Because it's like a graffiti instinct, you know, it's in you already. Like if you have a marker on you see a nice clean wall, you can say, wow, beautiful clean wall, all this space for myself. You start writing all kinds of things, doing all the designs you want, everything. You go wild on war. You do everything that comes to your imagination.
It is definitely vandalism, an act of deliberate vandalism. I feel it's something that is done with plan. It's not something that's done within a matter of moments. These young people actually sit down and plan a design.
It's an expression. It's an expression of themselves. It is one way that they can make a mark on the world.
Very, very imaginative. They have wonderful imaginations. They're absolutely incredible.
I think it's really foolishness. People just don't have nothing to do, so they just go right on the wall or anything. They should take that home. Right on their walls at home. It makes the city look very stupid.
It's like a group of guys, yeah. You know, like just certain guys, like say from my neighborhoods, me and a couple of other guys. And we like, when we write, we all go together. And that's like our writing clique. But there's other guys that go with their friends and they got writing cliques. Yeah, like SSB, 3YB, that's 3 Yard Boys. Mm-hmm. 3 Yard Boys. SSB, South Stone Brothers. There's a whole lot of writing cliques.
And let your name be known to others. When you write it, like, say like if you write it, somebody come around and say, oh wow, that's your name? You say, yeah. So you can put a name that sounds good. Then you write it, different colors. You put different colors and that's the look of the sound good.
Well, I feel that some people, they just get a kick out of doing it, that's all. They just like to do it. They see everybody else do it. They figure they might as well do it too.
Like if you're in a gang, right, and that certain person don't like you and they see your name up there, sometimes they try to overwrite your name with their name like that. Or like if you see somebody and your name is up there and it's one of your friends, you say, hey, you write some nice graffiti, man. You know, like, wow, teach me, because I ain't never did it before.
An individual's expression of his own manlyhood is staking out a section of ground as his own, as much as a dog would by tinkling on a fire hydrant.
We had certain preconceived notions that these essentially were children from minority groups, kids from broken homes, and essentially this was their outlet. Some of them pulled fire alarm boxes, others mocked up. We found that it was not a minority. People, kids from broken homes or poor homes. This went right across the spectrum.
There's nobody that would be able to stop these kids from painting the graffiti. There aren't enough police to arrest rapists and murderers, so nobody could have tried to stop these kids from painting the graffiti.
We go to the courts. Yes, that they couldn't even be interested in this. We go to the district attorneys, and the guy says, bring me a mugger, bring me a rapist.
Tremendous amount of beauty involved.
Starting to appreciate that talent.
brand new talent that we're now seeing for the first time. A new art form that is amazing.
The city fathers have stated that it is an art form of sorts, and that the youth that occupy themselves with this practice should be permitted to do it, to express their artistic capabilities. However, I think the entire situation has gotten out of hand, and I see absolutely nothing nice about it whatsoever.
It ruins the walls or anything that the paint is being used on. It just makes it look awful. I think it's an expression by the kids, though. They want to express something, dissatisfaction, or something they feel bad about, anything, you know, so they feel like they could express it by painting on a wall.
I think it's a step in the right direction, although it's a slow step. We need something a lot more revolutionary. Whatever message it wants to convey has to be dug out of it. I look at it, right? But often I can't see the message. I can't hear it, but I know it's there. The message is revolution.
It's an expression of the built-up anxieties and passions of these youngsters who have not had an opportunity to channel it in any particularly constructive way. And it is part and parcel a reflection of our society as a whole.
And they do it because they're alienated. This is a hostile society in which they live. They're frustrated, they have all this pent-up energy. Where do they direct it? So they direct it there. Why? Because if they direct it elsewhere, what happens? The Black Panthers wiped out in one shot, right? Young lords, any one of them, they could be wiped out. All they do is just direct the police at them. And that's the end of them. Now, what can these kids do? They can't go into a violent type of rebellion, so they have to go for the quiet type. Now, that's all subdued, isn't it? I would rather see them tear that building down than decorate it. Because it's still an eyesore, no matter how much you beautify it.
Society can spend billions on armaments and finds it difficult to spend billions on uplifting our environments, then we are witnessing what happens.
Our fathers who came to this country in the early 1800s put up beautiful memorials and city buildings, and also the subway trains are all destroyed by this senseless mocking of everything. I can't understand. Let's ride.
Fingerprinted and I get a record. Right. I can't afford that.
No way.
Second, you know, you get tired after 4 years.
4 years? You're kidding. Oh my God. How many trains do you think you painted?
A lot of trains.
A lot of trains. Yeah. Well, you could turn that artist's work into something profitable, don't you think? Yeah. Okay, good luck to you.
I think the graffiti in New York really typifies a certain very special energy that happens here that bubbles over into a graphic visual form. We find it on walls, we find it on streets, but I think the special attraction is on the subway cars. They really do a bang-up job. The thing that really, I find very exciting, is waiting for the subway train, and sometimes you will get a glorious one that arrives decorated like a birthday cake. Everything but the sparklers. It'll be just wall to wall, cover to cover, door to door. The whole thing is covered totally. I love these. And it's too bad that I have to then get on the train and be in the inside. I can't look at the outside anymore.
The public see these cars all mocked up, and they feel if these people can do this to the trains, then it indicates a failure of the system to protect its property, and if it can't protect its property, how is it going to protect its passengers? Some of them equate the markings on the car with dirt, filth, poor service, and an existence of crime in the subways.
I take a
recycled
single panel in every wagon, and I've tagged countless of wagons, because every time I go, I tag 40, 50 wagons. Tag, I can do in a split second, very, very fast. And when you want to do the outside, you rack spray paint, sealing it, and you just put your name up.
It's damage which costs millions of dollars to try and remove.
I forgot what it cost the city a few thousand dollars to repaint one car.
Yeah.
They repaint it one day, the next day it's all graffiti again.
They've gone through, I don't know, numerous compounds to try, even try coating the trains with Teflon to see if they could steam it off.
People were horrified in the 60s when this came along and how awful the subway cars and these plastic vinyl surfaces were being destroyed. I thought it was marvelous because these lousy plastic vinyl surfaces, which are very boring to sit on the subway and look at, were being destroyed. I think it's great. I love to sit on the subway and try to figure out these things and read them and look at them. I think it's a very expressive, if you will, folk art. It really comes into the category of folk art for me. Where do you ride mostly?
Mostly? The layups, where to keep the trains on the weekend.
And how do you get in to do that?
With a key, or sometimes the doors are open. We just go inside, a whole bunch of us, all the riders, and we just, you know, start marking up all over, inside, the outside, every place.
The key I have is the 400 key, and it's the master key for all the trains in New York City. And I got this key from my friend, and he let me make a copy of it. And how they originally got it, you can either get it from a conductor or a motorman, and the way you get it, you have to steal it from them. Take the whole bunch of keys, and from then on you can make 1,000 copies and distribute them along all your friends. And you go at the end of the station, you jump down and go in between the cars, open the car up and get inside. And you have to be careful, because as soon as you go down, the third rail is right on the side. And if you step inside the third rail, well, you're dead. So you have to either climb on top of it, just stay away from it, whatever you do. By accident, I've touched the third rail with my sneaker, and I just burned a hole right through it.
It's pretty dangerous. You can get caught by the cops, get beat up, you could get electrocuted, hit by a train, anything could happen. Sometimes they beat you up, they let you go, take your paint. Sometimes they'll spray you with your own paint. They took one kid and they sprayed him red, white, and green, his hair and his whole body. They made him look like a flag.
Some of them have told me that that's what they get off on, going in the yards, running away from the guards, you know, who are in the train yards. One young man, he was painting one train all night. Early morning, he heard the electricity go on, so he picked up his shopping bag full of spray cans, 26 of them, and it exploded and killed him. Some of them hang on the side of the trains, believe it or not, and paint as the trains are moving. I mean, it's devastating.
We find that there is only a small number, probably from 500 to 1,000, who are ritualistic graffitiists. They use the subway cars as the means of obtaining identification. They have like a batting average, the numbers of cars that they have marked up, the different lines in which they've operated in. They very often have inspection groups where they will sit at a particular vantage point and mark off the scores of the various cars that have been defaced by the different individuals.
May leave 205th Street and go all the way out to Stowell Avenue. And that train can be seen by other members that want to see their writing or by other members that are writers.
We stay on some stations and we watch our names pass by, see who does the best ones, you know. Check out everybody else's work and check out your work too.
I like to see my name go by. It's training, it gives me a good feeling, you know, just see my name there.
Something that's in us and, you know, like you want to let it out, a way of expressing yourself, saying something.
Sometimes I spend a long time, a couple of hours watching trains, taking pictures, just spending time with the writers, hanging out, doing anything. Just as long as it has to do with graffiti.
People on platforms and stuff, you know, they look at what is that garbage saying, all this stuff. But people that write, they know what it says.
My piece, my name, watch my name go by.